Good morning, students, and welcome to the class. As you all know that we have completed the second book. In the previous class, we have completed the last chapter of the second book. And now the syllabus is complete. And from today onwards, there will be revision of all the chapters. And we are again going back to first book, that is Contemporary World Politics. And we will start from the first chapter. And in this regard, it must be there in your mind that we all are knowing all these things, that the syllabus has been changed for this session 2020-21. The CBSE has changed the syllabus, and accordingly we see that some chapters have been completely deleted, and some portions from some chapters have been deleted. And not only this, there is only reduction of the syllabus. Actually, some chapters are deleted, some portions are deleted, but at the same time we see that some new subtopics have been added in some of the chapters. So during this time, when we are going to revise, we are going to restart from the first chapter of the first book, we will discuss according to the revised syllabus. And our first chapter is Cold War. In the original book, in the old book, it is Cold War. But in the revised syllabus, the name has been changed. Now the name of the first chapter of the first book is Cold War and Non-Aligned Movement, as you can see it here. Okay. But in the first chapter, we see that there is no change in the syllabus. Nothing has been deleted and nothing has been added. It is the same chapter. So you will have to do accordingly. Chapter 1 provides a type of background to the entire book. Because the book is Contemporary World Politics, and this Contemporary World Politics has started with the end of the Second World War. Okay, so in this chapter we will consider the Cold War and the Non-Aligned Movement. So in order to understand the Cold War, we need to understand about the Second World War. The Second World War, it was started in 1939 and it lasted in 1945. This was the duration of the Second World War, and there were two parties in the war. One was Allied power, and the second was Axis power. These were the two parties who fought this Second World War. Second World War ki jo ladai hui, wo in do groups ke beech mein hui. Ek taraf jo group of nation tha, unko hum Allied power kehte hain, aur dusri taraf jo group of nation tha, usko hum Axis power kehte hain. Okay? So in this Allied power, the important countries who were there in this Allied power were US, UK, USSR, and France. There were many other countries, but they were the leaders. These US, United States of America, United Kingdom, then Union of Socialist Soviet Republic and France. These countries were the leader of Allied power. And on the other hand, there were Axis power, and the leader of this group were Germany, Japan, and Italy. These are the three countries who led this group. So you must know that this war is known as World War. And what does it mean? It means that this war is not limited only to the continent of Europe, but actually this war had involved almost all the major powers of the world, all the important powers, all the powerful countries of the world were involved in this war. And this war was spread to regions which were outside Europe, like Southeast Asia, then China, Myanmar, which was at that time called Burma, and also parts of India's northeast. So this that is the reason this is known as a World War. And the impact of this Second World War was devastating for the whole world, because there was so much loss of lives, so much loss of property, and so much destruction was caused by this Second World War that the world cannot afford to go for the Third World War. So the impact was very bad. And in this regard, we must understand that how this Second World War ended. Kaise end hua Second World War ka? The Second World War ended with the use of nuclear weapon, nuclear bomb, by United States of America in the two cities of Japan, that is Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So Hiroshima, in this city the bomb was dropped on 6th of August 1945 and Nagasaki on this city the bomb was dropped on 9th August 1945. Now there is a controversy regarding this use of this nuclear bomb on the two cities of Japan by USA. There are many who are of the view that Japan was about to surrender. It was going to surrender in the Second World War, and there was no need of using this nuclear bomb against Japan. If US अगर US ने ये बॉम्ब नहीं भी गिराया होता तो भी वॉर ख़त्म होने जा रहा था, बिकॉज जापान सरेंडर करने जा रहा था. फिर भी US ने इस बॉम्ब को यूज़ किया, एंड वी ऑल नो द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ यूजिंग दिस बॉम्ब. सो मैनी लाइव्स have lost, so many loss of property. This use of this war, we can say it was a very devastating effect on Japan. Not only Japan, but it was against the cause of humanity. So now we will have to analyze दिस कि व्हेन जापान वाज गोइंग टू सरेंडर व्हाई यूएस यूज्ड न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब व्हाई यूएस ड्रॉप्ड न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब ऑन द टू सिटीज ऑफ जापान. देयर इज रीजन बिहाइंड दिस बिकॉज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यूएस first of all you must understand that before second world war there was dominance of europe over the whole world especially britain and france these were the most powerful countries of the whole world hai na सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर स्टार्ट होने के पहले तक का जो कंडीशन था पूरे वर्ल्ड का उसमें हम क्या देखते हैं कि यूरोप वॉज द मोस्ट पावरफुल कॉन्टिनेंट एंड इन दिस यूरोप स्पेशली ब्रिटेन एंड फ्रांस वर द मोस्ट पावरफुल कंट्रीज द पुअर कंट्रीज ऑफ एशिया एंड अफ्रीका वर द कॉलोनीज ऑफ दीज पावरफुल यूरोपियन कंट्रीज वी वर ऑल्सो वन एमंग देम. India was also the colony of Britain. So, पूरी दुनिया पे British दबदबा था जिसको हम कह सकते हैं and बहुत बड़ा था British Empire and what was said about the British Empire कि British Empire का सूरज कभी अस्त नहीं होता. The sun never sets in the British Empire. The empire was so big कि किसी न किसी empire के किसी न किसी part पे कभी न कभी sun का ray पड़ता रहता था. This is geographical. The statement has geographical explanation. Empire इतना बड़ा था कि वो किसी न किसी British Empire के किसी न किसी portion पे किसी न किसी part पे सन का रे पड़ता रहता था. वहाँ डे टाइम होता था बिकॉज ऑफ वास्टनेस बिकॉज ऑफ लार्ज एम्पायर. सो दिस वॉज द पावर ऑफ ब्रिटेन बिफोर सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर एंड द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट इम्पैक्ट वी कैन से the most important impact of this second world war was end of the supremacy of europe over world politics. world politics pe jo europe ki supremacy thi before second world war during second world war mein itne zyada usko loss hota hai. financial condition jo hoti hai wo europe ki bahut hi buri ho jati hai. europe ko kaha jata hai jo continent क्रेडिटर्स का कॉन्टिनेंट था वो क्रेडिटर्स से डेप्टर्स में चेंज हो जाता है. तो यूरोप जो थी वो पूरी तरह से डिवेस्टेटेड हो जाती है बिकॉज ऑफ सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. और इसी के साथ हम देख रहे हैं व्हाट वी आर सीइंग अमेरिका एंड यूएसएसआर इन एक्सिस पावर. देर आर फोर कंट्रीज यूएसए यूएसएसआर यूके एंड ब्रिटेन फ्रांस. सो यूके एंड फ्रांस की कंडीशन तो बिल्कुल खराब हो गई. अब बचे कौन यूएसए एंड यूएसएसआर. सो दीज टू कंट्रीज वर नाउ इमर्जिंग एज द सुपर पावर्स आफ्टर द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. अब ये दो कंट्री जो है ये सुपर पावर के फॉर्म में इमर्ज कर रहे थे. ठीक है एंड नाउ व्हाट वी फाइंड दैट इवन बिफोर द एंड ऑफ द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर what started rivalry between these two superpowers. ye USA aur USSR ke beech ki jo rivalry thi actually that rivalry started even before the end of the second world war and this incident is the proof of this. the reason behind using these nuclear bombs against Japan by USA is that USA wanted to stop Soviet Union from making military and political gains in Asia, especially in Asia. because USA was knowing that after the Second World War, if there is anyone who can compete with him, who can stand by him, who can stand opposite him, अमेरिका के अगेंस्ट जो खड़ा हो सकता था वो USSR ही था पूरी दुनिया में. तो ये जो सोच है कि बाई यूजिंग दिस न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब, ये दिखाया जा रहा है अमेरिका की तरफ से कि वी आर मोर पावरफुल, अमेरिका इज मोर पावरफुल देन USSR. USSR के पावर्स कम है अमेरिका से, क्योंकि अमेरिका ने न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब यूज़ किया. उस समय तक कभी भी किसी ने भी न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब यूज़ नहीं किया था. अमेरिका वॉज द फर्स्ट कंट्री टू यूज़ दिस न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब. तो ये न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब को इसलिए यूज़ किया गया ताकि वो USSR को ये दिखा सके कि USA इज़ द सुप्रीम. तो जो लड़ाई है USA और USSR की, जिसके बारे में अभी हमें देखना है, कोल्ड वॉर इज ओनली अबाउट दिस वॉर, दिस कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन USA एंड USSR. तो ये जो कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग रिलेशनशिप है, इट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम जस्ट फ्रॉम द एंडिंग ऑफ द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. तो ये जो बॉम्ब गिराया गया उसके पीछे यही इंटेंशन था कि अपने आप को सुपीरियर प्रूफ करना, पूरी दुनिया ये समझे कि अमेरिका इज द मोस्ट पावरफुल कंट्री, और USSR का जो इन्फ्लुएंस है उसको कम करना एशिया में, पर्टिकुलरली इन एशिया. वो किसी भी तरह का मिलिट्री और पॉलिटिकल गेन नहीं कर पाए बिकॉज USSR लोकेशन, जिस तरह का USSR का है, इट कैन गेन सो मच इन एशिया. अपने इन्फ्लुएंस बहुत सारी कंट्रीज पे वो यूज़ कर सकता था, तो कैसे उसको रोका जाए ताकि वो अपने कम से कम मिलिट्री और पॉलिटिकल गेन पा सके बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स पावर. तो ये दिखाना कि हम तुमसे ज़्यादा पावरफुल हैं, दैट वॉज द मेन रीज़न बिहाइंड यूजिंग दिस न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब इन द सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर. दो देर वेर आर्ग्यूमेंट्स इन फेवर ऑफ यूजिंग दीज न्यूक्लियर बॉम्ब्स बाई द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका. Those who support, they are of the opinion that it was very much important to end the war quickly. So many people, so many army men, army personnels were dying in Japan. So in order to stop loss of American lives and allied lives, it was important to drop these nuclear weapons on these two cities. So we don't have to go in argument in very detail. We just have to understand that this end of Second World War, actually this end of Second World War started a new equation of power in the world politics. And in this equation of power, we see that two new powers emerged on the global politics. And these two new powers are USA and USSR. So now we have seen that the rivalry between US and USSR has started even before the end of the Second World War. And with the end of the Second World War, there emerged these two superpowers, and there were a very high level of competition and rivalry existed between these two superpowers. Because rivalry kinke beech mein hoti hai, competition kinke beech mein hoti hai, competition unhi ke beech mein hoti hai jinke power equate kiya ja sakta hai, jisko lagta hai ki hum उसको पा सकते हैं. सपोज एक स्टूडेंट को 100 में 91 आता है एंड द अदर स्टूडेंट इज अदर स्टूडेंट गेट्स 93, and there is a third student who gets 72. So what will be the nature of competition? Who will compete? Only two students who got 91 and 93, they will compete with each other. Jisko 74 aaya hai, 72 aaya hai, he will not be able to compete. तो जब भी कंपटीशन होती है तो वो जो दो इक्वल थोड़ा ऊपर नीचे होते हैं उनके बीच में ही कंपटीशन होती है. कंपटीशन ऐसे नहीं होते एक यहाँ है और एक यहाँ है, इनके बीच में कंपटीशन का कोई मतलब नहीं है. तो ये कंपटीशन क्यों स्टार्ट हुआ? बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ देम वर इक्वल इन पावर एंड मोस्टली ऑल द एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ लाइफ, है ना. तो इस इक्वालिटी ऑफ पावर, दोनों के पास बराबर पावर थे, दोनों अपनी इस पावर को यूज करना चाहते थे अपनी इन्फ्लुएंस को इंक्रीज करने के लिए. एंड दैट इज व्हाई राइवलरी स्टार्ट हुई उनके बीच, कंपटीशन स्टार्ट हुआ, टेंशन स्टार्ट हुआ, कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी सिचुएशंस स्टार्ट हुए. सो ऑल दीज स्टार्टेड. बट हियर वन मोर थिंग इज देयर विच इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट, दैट बिटवीन USSR and USA there was ideological difference existed. It was not simple rivalry or for power. It's not that they were only competing with each other for getting power. There was ideological difference, there was ideological conflict between the two. And both of them represented different ideology. And both of them wanted to prove that their ideology is the best and the most appropriate way to organize social life, political life, and economic life. So they represented different ideologies, conflicting ideologies. Not only they were representing different ideologies, but they wanted to spread their ideology. They wanted that different countries of the world should follow their ideology, because both of them were claiming that their ideology was the best and the most appropriate way for the organization of political life, social life, and economic life. So, we will just see what is the ideological differences was there between these two countries. So, we see that the US was representing capitalist economy. Capitalism and liberal democracy. And on the other hand, USSR was representing socialism and communism. So these are the two ideologies which were represented by US and USSR, and these two ideologies were not different, but they were opposite to each other. And you have studied about these ideologies in your 11th book. It was there. The concept of socialism is also there, and the concept of liberalism and capitalism is also there. But still, I will just like to remind you so that things should be clear. Okay, so I'm just saying that the US was a capitalist economy, capitalist economy is that economy in which the resources of the country are owned by private individuals. They are the owner of the private individuals. This capitalism believes in market economy. Market economy means there should not be any kind of interference by the state. The economy should be free. Market economy means free economy, which is not controlled, which is not regulated by the state. The market is controlled by the two factors, demand and supply. The prices of the goods are fixed by these two factors, demand and supply. There is no intervention of government. And what is the reason behind adopting this capitalism economy, capitalist economy? What is the justification for making the market free? The justification is that they are of the opinion, the capitalist ideology is based on the opinion that in a society, everyone can get equality of opportunity only by free and fair competition. If there is free and fair competition, there is no partiality in the competition, then only the reward and the resources of the country will be distributed on the basis of merit. Jinke paas merit hoga, wo aage badhenge. So it's purely, it will be purely based on justice. Isme kisi tarah ka injustice nahi ho raha, injustice nahi ho raha hai. Har kisi ko equal rights hai compete karne ka, because competition is free and fair. So this capitalism is based on the concept of freedom, ki the economic activities of an individual should not be controlled by the government. If the government is controlling the economic activities of the country, then there will be lack of freedom. And in this type of condition, if there is lack of freedom, then it will hamper the growth of personality of the individual. So this capitalism is based on the ideology of freedom. They give more importance to the ideology of freedom. On the other hand, this socialism supports state-controlled economy. Socialists are of the view that the economy should not be free. If economy is free, if we adopt market economy, then it will benefit only the richer section of the society. It will never be beneficial for the poorer section of the society. So in order to give benefit to the poor section of the society, in order to protect the interest of the poor section of society, what is required? That the state must control the economy. The state must regulate the economy. Then only the economy can move in the direction of maintaining equality in the society. Otherwise, if we are following this capitalist economy, then in this capitalist economy, because of individual ownership of the resources, there will be such situation in which only rich people will be benefited and it will be detrimental for the interest of the poor people. So in order to protect the interest of the poor people, the socialist ideology supports that there must be control of government in the economy. The economy must be controlled by the government, ताकि government उसको गरीबों के welfare के direction में ले जा सके. Okay? So we will discuss other issues in the next class.